This is a small development that we did in Mexico City. Now, one thing when you start looking at some of our foreign work and you go, wait a second, that's not all the space and, you know, openness that you would typically see in an American subdivision that we work on. But keep in mind that the plan that we started with is typically the smallest possible lots in the tightest situation. And what we do is we're squeezing out every little inch of the site that we can to create some interest that otherwise wouldn't be there. Now, on these small sites here, you know, we really can't do a PUD that we can in the U.S. We have to really make sure that we hold on to every existing minimum that would be typical of that foreign country, because if we deviate any, it really raises flags. So these were the units that we were furnished originally. And then what we do is we work with them as best we can to get some kind of staggering, to get some kind of change in scale, just something that you don't see this constant, just mindless row upon row of straight homes. You'll notice that there's a central community center. And, you know, so we want to try and get these, the pool and clubhouse as close as we can to the central part of the development. The scale is different than American development. You'll see that while there's some units that offer units over the park cars, for the most part, this would be a parking spaces of two lanes with gravel in between. I'm showing stone that you park the car. So two paved lanes per car, like they did in the old American neighborhoods. And, you know, there's the architecture is kind of interesting. You can see the rear yards are very minuscule. Space is very tight. Density is very high. This would be very, very typical of Latin American high-dense neighborhoods. But what we're doing is we're adding as much value and character as the constraints that we're given. Again, the original plan, if you could just imagine these units jammed in with no increased census space, no interest, and the same density. We did save some infrastructure here. But, you know, this would be very typical of Mexican multifamily developments we work on.